You are about to hear one of the loudest noises ever heard in a One Championship arena. This man is home.
Aung, the Burmese Python! Aung,
take a good look in the mirror and ask yourself, do you have what it takes to be number one?
And the rain of gold continues for Aung San Suu Kyi, the most famous man in Myanmar, a cultural icon.
It's insane. I don't see myself as a celebrity. I don't see myself as a star. But when I do go to Myanmar, you can't deny it. If we go to restaurants, the waiters and, you know, the staff members, they're like so excited to see me and they want to take pictures. It's a very big honor for me. I try to be polite. I try to be good, whatever they want.
You can't like walk around in public. It's the crowd. I try to count and to estimate how many people are there. It's just too many to see. I mean, it goes for, it seems like miles, especially when he gets to talk in front of a big crowd. It's thousands of people. And not just in Myanmar. We went to Thailand recently. I was surprised that we literally could not walk the streets because he was getting stopped everywhere we went. People approached him and just thanked him for really putting Myanmar on the map. I think because he has a platform, he's trying to do a lot of good things.
I have a lot of following on social media. Whenever I post something, I always ask my question, is this going to positively affect the readers? So I always try to post something that's positive. Well, it comes with the responsibility of the fame. And you have little kids, you know, looking up to you. So it's important that I portray myself as a good human being. Let them know by doing good, you know, you can achieve great things as well. And I try to be a positive light. From the late night, it's time to shine. Early morning, rise and grind. You see the best, beat the best, so you can be the best. Then you go defeat the rest, till there's no people left. Winning's all that matters, and I can see you lost.
Instructions from Olivier Cox. There's nothing quite like it. The moment before an Aung San Suu Kyi world title match against his toughest opponent yet, in Ken Hasegawa, Michael Ciavello, Mitch Chosunwiki. Ken Hasegawa.
Aung San Suu Kyi looks very intense, while Hasegawa looks very relaxed.
A new training camp for Aung San Suu Kyi in Fort Lauderdale, Florida.
That right hand of Aung San Suu Kyi snuck right through the guard.
Right roundhouse kick from Aung San Suu Kyi. Hasegawa, the deep megaton, open weight champion, comes here very well credentialed. Bouncing left hand there from Ken Hasegawa. Omar showing patience, edges forward as the champion. Probing with the jab out of southpaw stance, Ken Hasegawa. Jab to the cross there from Hasegawa, just falls short for the Japanese martial artist. Outside leg kick misses the target from Aung San Suu Kyi. Second one connects for Aung San Suu
Kyi. Hasegawa's starting to find a home for that left hand. He's trying to gauge the distance as he's cutting through the guard of Aung San Suu Kyi. Right there, just landed again.
The left cross, the power cross of the southpaw from Japan. Body shot off the lead hand from Aung. Aung two-punch combination, grazing with the left. Goes to southpaw stance Aung.
Aung has landed a few times though, but Hasegawa was wearing it well.
Jab there from Aung Lan Sun, switches back to orthodox stance now. There's the champion. Hasegawa threads the high left roundhouse kick.
Nice little combination from Hasegawa, left hand, left kick.
They're going to change levels perhaps, mix it up a little here. Again, Hasegawa almost circles into that right roundhouse kick. The roundhouse kick that knocked out Machado. Fake there from Aung Lan. Thought about throwing the right hand down the tube. Resets from center cage. Left cross falls short for Hasegawa. An intriguing half a round down so far. Roundhouse kick to the upper left ribs there from Aung Lan.
These guys are very similar. Like they have very almost duplicate styles, like they're going against a mirror. They've got the same jab straight combination, same big roundhouse kick coming off the rear leg.
Every time Aung Lan lands, this crowd goes crazy. A sellout again inside the mighty Toyota Indoor Stadium. Hasegawa had some fire on the lead hand. Both men showing tremendous respect for the capabilities of one another. They give instruction coming from the corners. Aung Lan gets out of the way of the two-punch combo. Hasegawa resets. The southpaw. From Japan. Oh, the right hand! Smack bang! Smack bang! First real power salvo from Aung Lan Sun. And Hasegawa rallies back. Aung Lan applying the pressure, coming forward. Hasegawa locking eyes with the champion. Step freely, and Hasegawa backs him off with the right hand. Both men showing some terrific boxing so far here, Mitch.
These are big middleweights putting a lot of power behind these heavy hands.
Hasegawa, a game opponent with 25 seconds on the clock.
Hasegawa competing against one of the best middleweights in the world, the best middleweight in the world, but he's also got these 10,000 Myanmar fans against him as well.
And we are told that one in every three of this country of 55 million is watching live, watching their hero, Aung Lan Sun, defend the middleweight world title.
Take a look at some of Aung Lan's shots here. Look at that, he caught a kick. Caught a right hand on the chin, and then he got hit with a kick. That was the best combination of Ken Hasegawa, but Aung Lan comes right back with a nice overhand right of his own. Back and forth action, very close first round.
Wherever you're watching in 138 countries around the world, or live on the One Super App, we hope you're enjoying all the madness, all the mayhem, all the martial arts magnificence. That is one championship from Yangon, Myanmar. The middleweight world title of that match. Aung Lan Sun is on the line. He's a two-division champion.
Some wise words coming off of Henry Hooft, the head coach for Aung Lan Sun. As he tells him, he wants to make sure that he covers up a little bit better, make sure he puts his hands nice and tight to the chin.
Second round set for five. We are seeing a fantastic toe-to-toe matchup so far. Roundhouse kick to the ribs there from Aung Lan. Thumping right hand down the center corridor from the champion. Hasegawa backs him off with the lead hand. power in both hands of the southpaw.
Sagawa starting to march forward, trying to put punches together in bunches.
Aung's got to keep that left hand up because the right lead of Hasegawa is finding the mark.
That's what Henry Hove told him. He said he wants to keep his hands nice and close to his chin.
Very humid atmosphere inside Tawana Indoor Stadium. On Long Sun, looks to get on the inside. Hasegawa almost walked into that rising knee.
Hasegawa starting to push forward a bit more on his boxing. Cutting a little bit of angles. This is typically what we see from Aung La. Aung La likes to pivot out to the right and left very well.
A hook to a left cross there.
Look at the welt starting to develop on Hasegawa's left rear.
It is purple and deep red from the roundhouse kicks off the back leg of Aung La Sun. Hasegawa fights. Aung La fires out a front kick. Those booming chants go up again for Aung La Sun. He drops one down to the belly button. Hasegawa threads the left cross nicely. He's got a bit of pepper behind it. Aung La looks to close the gap. Stumbles backwards, clips him with a short right hook.
Looks like that caught him off balance though as Aung La stumbles backwards and a nice left or right hand from Hasegawa.
Hasegawa again, a popping jab. Takes another rib kick. Hasegawa's got some fire in his hands. Aung La taking his time, not overextending himself, not rushing. A cerebral performance from the champion. Jab cross combo there from the challenger. The cross lands again, but he didn't have the torque. He didn't turn into it. Toe to toe. Hasegawa comes forward, straight line punches. A high right roundhouse kick from Aung La. Hasegawa backs him off with another cross. Aung La takes two. Solid blows to the jaw. Got to keep the hands up, the champion. This is a good boxing spell here, Mitch, from the challenger.
Hasegawa's really putting his punches together nicely. He's finding the home. He's finding that range with his jab and his counter strike, and he's looking clean. Very good round so far for Hasegawa.
Hasegawa shoots in for a takedown, the first takedown attempt of the match, and Aung La stuffs it, and the knees down for the champion.
Burmese Python has a really good guillotine, so Hasegawa's got to be careful, make sure he keeps his head high on that entry.
Edges forward again, does the check. Aung La Sun, second round set for five for the world middleweight title clash. Little dipping body shot at the right hand there from Aung La. Flips him with a left hook. Body shot from Aung La. Throws out the front kick. What a battle we are seeing for the world title. Aung La, right hand lead. Hasegawa threads a right hand of his own, that being the lead hand of the southpaw.
In those close distance exchanges, that's Hasegawa's best time. He's starting to catch Aung La when Aung La's fighting.
Hasegawa cuts on the side of the right eye.
Ooh. Nice hook, straight combo.
Hasegawa jab two, follows through with another right hand. Aung La to right of his own, and Hasegawa now toe to toe. Aung La goes to the body, Hasegawa goes to the draw. Back and forth action to close out the second round. This crowd in Yangon, and I'm sure around the world, loving every moment of this world title match. And there's one of our luminaries, heavyweight superstar Alan Galani, here at Cape Side.
And- And who's the other guy? Po Ta, another Myanmar superstar. Look at this action. Watch this. Aung La tries to come up the middle with an uppercut just as Hasegawa attacks that low leg, sweeps it out from under him, creating a slight stumble from the champion. Hasegawa comes marching forward, throws two punches. Aung La fades out of the way. Boom, comes back with one of his own. The back and forth action is just tremendous as Hasegawa lands a big right hook.
Fantastic back and forth action. Both men landing heavy shoulders. The handiwork of Hasegawa in the second round. But there's a good look at the cut in a very dangerous spot.
And there's the
champion as he defends the crown. Third round of five.
Little mouse under the eye of the champion. Little cut under the eye of the challenger. Third round, here we go.
And sweat flies off the brow of both as they both land punches. Southpaw starts from Aung La. Hasegawa backs him off with the left hand. A beautiful left hook there from Hasegawa. A double jab from the Japanese challenger. Aung La, head kick,
the headache maker. Man, that reverberated all throughout the stadium.
Hasegawa back.
Position. Look for him to drop elbows and try to crucifix.
Aung La gets up. Aung La back to his feet, drills a body shot. This crowd is crazy. Uppercut from Aung La. Hasegawa tags him. Looks for the uppercut again. A downward elbow. A crossing elbow. Hasegawa does a quick count of his teeth. Goes to the body, trying to soften up the midsection. Hasegawa breathing heavy. There's a huge mouse swelling up the right eye of Aung La. Uppercut from the champion.
The challenger's mouth is wide open, but he's still coming forward. Aung La wisely starts to go to the body.
This is like something out of a Hollywood movie. Back and forth, a slugfest. A solid left cross there from Hasegawa. Aung La throws a roundhouse kick. The champ comes forward again. A bolo punch from the champion. A body rip to the liver. Hasegawa to the head. Corner to once more. This is guts. An intestinal fortitude personified. Both men letting it all hang out. They're pulling out all the stops.
Both guys have bit down on their mouthpiece and are just throwing hands.
This is what they came to see. This is pure theater. A right hand lands from Aung La's son. A wild leaping left is in Southpaw start for Chad. Hasegawa backs him off. Hasegawa's hands around his waist. This is epic. This is awesome.
The left eye of Aung La is starting to swell shut. Hasegawa's marching forward, landing shots.
What a shot. Toe again! They're giving it their all. This is one for the ages. Aung goes to the body.
Michael, and this is the only the third round. 40 seconds left. As Aung marches forward with a big stiff right jab.
Both of Aung's eyes are swollen now. Still the champ comes forward, goes to the sternum, backs up the challenger. Thought about a clinch and knee. 20 seconds remain in the third round as Hasegawa lands across to the jaw. Jab from the challenger. Jab two. This has been amazing. The atmosphere, the battle, the moment.
I like how Aung Lan is starting to go to the body. He's mixing it up. Hasegawa is just headhunting. Aung Lan is attacking the body just as much as he's attacking the head. Take a look at some of this action. There was a big exchange, but then the counter off the right hands, but then Aung Lan landed a sneaky uppercut with his right. Constant action from these two as they go toe to toe, back and forth, just landing big punches. Now, Michael, this is unseen territory for the challenger, Ken Hasegawa. He has never been into the championship rounds. He has never needed to see a fourth and fifth, and Aung Lan lives in deep water.
But look at the damage on Aung Lan's face, a sight we never see. Both eyes are swollen, also the damage on Ken Hasegawa. This has been something extraordinary. Fourth round, the penultimate round. They call these the championship round. It is one championship from Yangon, Myanmar, and it is a blockbuster. The cage door closes. Aung Lan's first stolen shot. And Hasegawa, as Mitch said, has to dig deep, has to go to a place inside of himself that he's never been to before. This is when it becomes more than physical. And Hasegawa shoots in, almost stops the takedown.
And I was trying to transition to the back. Hasegawa caught him, the mouth guard goes out.
Knees to the ribs. That'll make it even harder. Hasegawa wobbling around the cage. How much more does the challenger have left? It has been an absolute beauty, a rip slaughter. Aung Lan with the right hand, the body shots. Hasegawa tags him with the left cross. Hasegawa again. Both these men, more punch than a high school prom. There's a right hand from Aung Lan. There's a stiff uppercut. It's all boxing now. They're fighting on spirit. Spirit, and they've got to dig deep down into that well of intestinal fortitude. What have they got? What is keeping them going?
What's keeping Aung Lan going is this crowd. This is when the crowd is going to lift you and drive you, because you're competing for something bigger than yourself. You're competing for all these thousands of people that are rooting you on.
Has he gonna look at it? No, Hasegawa!
answering back, doubling up on the jabs, walking forward.
Aung's got to be wondering, what do I have to throw to make this man quit? What do I have to throw to knock this man out? But Hasegawa's still here. He's not going to wave the white flag. He's not going to go quietly into the night. And Hasegawa throws hands again.
Hasegawa has never been knocked out. Not once in his entire career has he been put to sleep. And this is why. These guys, their heads must be made of concrete as they trade big leather.
This is like a Rocky movie. This is like Creed versus Balboa. And it's Aung versus Hasegawa. A nice little trip takedown there from Aung. There, he's got the back. 1 minute remaining, fourth round of five.
1 minute left in the fourth round.
Throwing the back there, goes to the knees.
Knee to the head of Hasegawa. Continue to inflict damage.
I can go knees to the body. He's got the space. He can knee to the body here.
How is Hasegawa surviving? This is insane.
The left hand from Aung's son. Up one hook goes in. Aung might take the back with 30 seconds to go.
Can Hasegawa survive the round? Aung's son tries to get the second hook in to no avail. It's a turtle shell here from Hasegawa. Olivia Coast having a look at Hasegawa's face. And that punishes him even more. The electricity in here. You can feel it. Every hair in your body is tingling.
But Ken Hasegawa looks the worst of the two. But wow, look at this grappling exchange right here. Hasegawa continues to push forward. Aung sprawls out very heavy, gets control there in the clinch, throws a knee to the body as the mouthpiece goes down. Here was how they finished the round. Aung rolls into the rear naked choke. Looks like he's face cranking there. The choke's not in, it's a face crank. Hasegawa defends the hooks very well, still aware, completely aware of his surroundings, able to scramble back up on top, and then to finish with Aung on top. What a match!
One more round to go. Will Hasegawa crack? Or has he got the turbo to put the foot down in the business end, in the final round? Amazing scenes. There are matches across all sports that go down in history as simply unforgettable. This is one of them. This is unforgettable. And look at the sportsmanship. Look at the martial arts code of honor. Hasegawa is seen out of one eye.
Hasegawa's got to keep his guard up. Looking at the fresher of the two.
Both men throwing punches. A gripping left hand there from Aung's son. And sends the mouth guard of Hasegawa flying.
After this risky run, when your mouth hangs open like that, one well-placed punch and your mouthpiece will pop out.
Hasegawa jabs, backs off the champion with the left cross. Anything can happen in the sport of transition milliseconds. Spin it back over. The inner left leg of Aung Sun coming out on that occasion. A curling lead hand from the challenger. Backs up the champion again. Aung dances out of trouble. Goes to the body. Hasegawa misses with a lead uppercut. The crowd on the edge of their seats. In fact, most of them here are standing. Their national hero, Aung San, the most famous man in Myanmar. 3 minutes 20 away from possibly
What a beautiful trip takedown as Aung gets on top. Hasegawa is defending the hooks. And he can't let Aung wrap his legs around his body, but he gets back up.
Hasegawa defends. He's back to his feet. Almost halfway through the round. A jab from the champion. A cross and a jab from the arm heavy challenger. The gas tank on Hasegawa. Extraordinary. The durability. Aung La resets. Goes to the midsection of the lead hand. Eats a nice stiff jab from Hasegawa. Aung La switches back to his preferred orthodox stance. Under 2 minutes remaining, a knee to the midsection from the champion. Thrusts out a jab. Body shots. Hasegawa's ready to go.
Mr. Olivier Coast has put a stop to this contest after 3 minutes and 13 seconds in the fifth and final round. For your